Hi, my name is Erin Bertoli, and I am a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi & Associates. The following video is based on an article written by Dr. Stephen Hayes entitled, The Greatest Dangers Facing Behavior Analysts Today. Dr. Hayes is a professor in the Behavior Analysis Program at the University of Nevada. He has authored over 40 books and nearly 700 scientific articles. As the developer of relational frame theory, he has focused his career on an analysis of human language and cognition and the application of this to acceptance and commitment therapy. His work has been extremely influential in my own study of RFT and ACT and has sparked what I will refer to as a healthy skepticism of where our field is going and my own work as a behavior analyst. Of course, I will always work in accordance with the BACB task list. But I'm very grateful and respective of the fact that the fifth edition is coming out in 2022 and hope that our field continues to expand our scope of practice. Because as a wise man once said, if we do what we've always done, then we'll get what we've always gotten. In this article, Dr. Hayes states that behavior analysis is underfunded, undertaught, and underappreciated. He believes that there are dangers lurking that can hurt behavior analysts and our field as a whole. He proposes six dangers that I feel all behavior analysts should consider if we're going to expand our field and take our science to new levels. As we all know, behavior analysis was originally focused on animal learning. But as Skinner explained, the importance of a science of behavior derives largely from the possibility of an eventual extension to human affairs. Our mission from the very start was to understand complex human behavior. Where are the experimental analyses of emotion, friendship, sexuality, health, reasoning, humor, intelligence, and so on? As time has passed, both basic and applied behavior analysis has narrowed. It seems ABA is now a subfield of developmental disabilities, and that original mission has gotten lost. The second is tool polishing. Oh, how behavior analysts love our principles. Principles of behavior are our tools and are ways of speaking about the prediction and influence of the historically and currently situated actions of organisms that are precise, broadly applicable, and coherent in terms of the larger fabric of science. Yes, principles are our tools, but we may need to focus less on these shiny tools and focus more on all they can fix. Behavior analysis is a pragmatic discipline. Are we using our tools to unlock the complexity of human behavior? Or are we just polishing them up to use them again and again on the same problems? The third is the joy of precise irrelevance. At various times throughout our field's existence, preparations arise that offer an opportunity to deal with greater complexity and take steps toward expanding our field. But after the initial excitement, we sometimes lose our way and forget why these preparations are important to begin with. One example of this that Dr. Hayes gives in his article is stimulus equivalence. In some researchers' hands, it has gone from an outcome that orients the field to key process issues in the analysis of language to an end in and of itself. Equivalence has already been studied for 25 years, and if we continue to consider it as an end in itself, where are we going with it? We cannot waste another 25 years in extremely precise irrelevancy. The next is danger of hero worship. Now, this is a bold one. Dr. Hayes is one of my most respected and inspiring leaders in our field, but here he is putting down our forefather, the late and great B.F. Skinner. But what he's presenting does make a lot of sense. He speaks of other intellectual fields that are associated with a great leader and how one of two things usually happen. The field becomes a kind of living memorial, or the great leader is set aside as an honored parent, primarily of historical interest. He argues that if Skinner's ideas are of sufficient current interest, then we will develop, use them, and write our own literature, making his ancient texts a lot less necessary. If the books are needed because others are not expressing these ideas, or are not doing so in a way that maintains their integrity, vitality, or original meaning, then behavior analysis is a field in which old is better than new. Is that what we want? The alternative he proposes is our field to embrace a post-Skinnerian era. He is not proposing that someone else should assume Skinner's place, as he feels that the era of great leaders is forever in our behavioral science. But maybe our field moves Skinner into his rightful place as a historical antecedent of contemporary behavior analysis. The fifth is the danger of self-righteousness. Behavior analysts do a lot of hard work without a lot of pay. The reward is more social, where a good scientist earns respect. But Dr. Hayes points to signs that behavior analytic culture is beginning to reward sameness and rigidity over an increased ability to predict and influence important behavior with precision, scope, and depth. He fears that we are more satisfied with familiar behavioral wraps than with making a difference in the larger body of science. For example, all of the successful work with direct contingency analysis, and warns us that relatively narrow areas of interest are dominating the field. Is our field really expanding? Because a field not busy being born is a field that is busy dying. All of these dangers combine in this last warning, a failure to replicate. While the number of master's level behavior analysts are exploding, there are way too few at the PhD level. He warns us about the integrity and quality of these few doctoral programs and is fearful of the low number of qualified candidates to teach in these programs, some of which are not explicitly behavior analytic. The field is aging, and as some of our brightest behavior analysts leave, they are not being replaced. Yes, these dangers seem bleak, and maybe they're a bit of a stretch, but they've certainly made me reflect on what kind of behavior analyst I want to be and where I want my field to go. And I think as a community, maybe we need to be a little bit more skeptical in order to do everything we can to ensure that our field continues to expand, that we continue to push the envelope, refuse to accept interpretation and be true scientists, be open to new theories when the data is pointing us in that direction, and get back to our field's original mission of being a comprehensive experimental account of all psychology and address complex human behavior. Because it is not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to change. So what are your thoughts on this? Thoughts on entering a post-Skinnerian era? Please leave your comments below and subscribe to receive more content and help disseminate the science of behavior analysis.